Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science on Location. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Did you know that in terms of exports, coffee is the second largest traded commodity in the world, second only to oil? Recent food safety legislation has placed coffee among several commodities being monitored for ochratoxin A. Ochratoxin A is a naturally occurring toxin that has been linked to acute kidney toxicity, immune suppression, and even cancer. Whoever thought drinking coffee could be so dangerous? Let's head back to VICAM, a waters business, to take a closer look at a way to test this toxin from field to port and beyond. Hi, Elise. I'm so glad I found you.
Hi, Jen. How are you?
Good. So I just drank all this coffee, and I'm really afraid that I'm full of mycotoxins now.
Oh, my goodness. Take a deep breath. You only have to worry about one mycotoxin in coffee, and that's ochratoxin A.
Okay, but if I heat my coffee up, wouldn't it just go away?
Not at all. Ochratoxin A is a small molecule that's produced by molds, and it's on the bean. But the coffee producers test the coffee before it gets to your cup to make sure that ochratoxin A doesn't make it that far.
All right. Well, just to make sure, I actually brought the ground coffee that I had, and maybe we could test it.
I've got to stop you again. Not this coffee. What you really need is the green coffee, the beans before they're processed and roasted.
All right. Maybe you can take me to a whiteboard and show me the process.
Sure. No problem. Okay, so let me explain to you what ochratoxin A is. So it's a mycotoxin, as we said. Those are small molecules that are the secondary metabolites of certain molds or filamentous fungi. And ochratoxin A in particular, this is what it looks like, this molecule here. It is nephrotoxic, so it's very toxic to kidneys, and it is a known carcinogen. So this is something that's pretty highly regulated in a number of different commodities, including coffee. So those coffee producers will test the coffee beans at different stages of production, right from harvest through storage through to export, right up until it's roasted. Different stages of the production process require different types of testing options, of which there are a number. More traditionally, people might use something like our OchraTest immunoaffinity column alongside a fluorometer or maybe an HPLC or UPLC unit. But what we're really moving towards now is more rapid testing, such as that with our Ochra-V lateral flow test strip and Virtu reader.
Elise, that was really interesting. Could we maybe do a sample?
Sure, let's do it. So start off with our green coffee beans. We've seen these before. These are ground and homogenized into this kind of sandy-like texture that we have here. And with our test, you only need 5 grams of this in one of these tubes. You add some of our aqua premix solution, which is great actually, it has no solvents in. So all of our Virtu tests are very green. So you add your 25 mls and you mix it really well for 2 minutes. You usually vortex it. And then that solution goes through one of these fluted paper filters and we're left with this clear but colored extract, which is what we want to load onto our test strip.
Great.
So if I just get rid of this filter, we have here our solution that we're going to load onto one of our Ochra-V strip tests, which are stored in these little foil pouches because they must be kept dry until you're ready to use the test. So you can see this is the sample loading port, so we're going to put our filtered extract into this port, 100 microliters. So it's not a lot of volume, and you have to be very steady so you don't have too much coffee before you do
this. So I can do it, I'd be too shaky.
Exactly. So just drop by drop onto the strip, and that's it. We leave it for 5 minutes.
Okay.
When it's developed, we can read it in our Virtu reader here.
Okay.
So I have a test strip here that I developed earlier, and you can see it's got two lines. There's the test line and the control line, and the ratio of the intensity of those lines is determined by the reader, and with a calibration that will give you a number in parts per billion of how much ochratoxin A was in your coffee sample.
Wow, that's really sensitive.
Yes, yes. Yeah, 1 part per billion is like looking for a pinch of salt in 10 tons of potato chips.
Wow, so it's a very sensitive test and it looks really easy. Let's do some more samples.
Great.
Advances in the development of rapid diagnostic testing technologies are enabling more precise, rugged monitoring of ochratoxin A in both field and laboratory testing environments. Accurate, precise data is critical for coffee producers who operate in rugged tropical and subtropical regions where a laboratory may not be readily accessible. and also for exporters who desire to verify compliance prior to shipment. To learn more about the tools you saw today, go to the links below. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science on Location.